Well, hello everyone and welcome to Play by Play, or PXP for short. I'm your host, Jamie Yarrow, and this is part four of the series on success habits. Today we're going to be talking about making situations a win-win for everyone. Are you ready to get started? All right, here we go. Well, welcome back everyone. This is part four on our series on success habits. Now, be sure you go back and listen to the previous episodes if you missed them. Today, we're going to tackle a topic that requires us to put our selfishness on the table for just a minute, and we're going to have to think about the other people involved. The idea is that we want to create a circumstance where everyone wins. Now, let's be honest. Most of us, if we got right down to it, we can be pretty selfish at times. We're going to make sure that we're taken care of in the end, right? Now, before you jump on me, I understand there's times when that is really important. Look, I'm a parent, and oftentimes we're putting the needs of our kids first, and that's okay. But let's break away from that familial relationship, if you will. And let's talk about how you feel about those that you work with or those that you do business with. See, in most circumstances, that changes the dynamic a little bit. But there is still a way to make it a win-win for everyone. Yes, it's going to take work. And yes, you're going to have to think outside the box. It's going to take being open-minded and considerate of everyone else that's involved. But look, in most circumstances, you can do it. Oftentimes, what we see, though, is people either A, they compromise their position and they end up losing some of what they want. They give up some of their ground. Or B, they end up not giving enough consideration to the needs of others, and then they sort of take advantage of the situation. Now, some might tell you that the best thing to do is to just compromise. But look, when you do that, each person is having to give up pieces to their own puzzle. On the other hand, what if all the parties involved could end up winning? That's a win-win, right? A win-win situation. That's what we're talking about today. I was reading an article about the character traits of a win-win personality, and there were three things that stuck out. Now, first of all, integrity. And in this case, integrity means that you're sticking to your values, you're sticking to your commitments. You're not giving up on what you want. And second was maturity. And this is where it gets a little dicey, right? When you get into situations where people feel like they might be losing something and that, you know, someone else might be gaining something, it can create a tenuous environment. And it's here where most of these opportunities to create a win-win situation, this is where they fall apart. In order for it to be a win-win, everybody has to act, now get this, professional, fair, considerate. Those are hard things to do sometimes, right? But at the same time, we have to maintain a measure of courage so that we can stick to the desires and the needs and the wants that we have. Now, communication is absolutely key. You cannot get to a win-win situation without, you know, good, solid, open, courageous communication. The last trait of a win-win personality is the belief that there's plenty for everyone. There's enough to go around, and it's that abundance mentality, right? Just because someone else gets what they want in a deal, that doesn't mean that you can't too, or vice versa. Just because you're going to get what you want out of a deal doesn't mean that someone else can't get everything that they want as well. There almost is always a way to make it a win-win situation. So much of getting to a win-win situation involves the manner in which we communicate. Have you ever heard the saying, it's not always what you say, but oftentimes the way that you say it? Well, the same goes for a situation like this. Oftentimes, we're not looking for solution number one that benefits me most, or solution number two that might benefit you most. But we're looking for solution number three. That's the solution that benefits both of us. But too often we go into it looking for solution one for us, and they go into it looking for solution number two for them. And we try to get the other party to come to our solution. We try to bring them over to our side instead of both parties taking a step back, finding mutual ground, and trying to find solution number three, where it's a win-win for everybody. It's like a negotiation at times, right? In our manner of communication, the words that we choose, the interest that we put in other people's needs, they all play into the openness and the reception that we get from the other parties that are involved. We've got to be genuinely interested in their needs while at the same time holding firm to what we want. You've got to be empathetic yet confident. You've got to be understanding but yet courageous. Look, more times than not, there's a win-win solution for everyone. The challenge is, can we be professional and open-minded enough to reach that end goal? Well, folks, that's all the time I've got for you today. Thanks so much for listening to Play by Play. If you like the podcast, please share it with your circle. Remember, we're a replica of the five closest friends that we have, and chances are, if you like the podcast, they will too. Most of all, though, we hope that something that was said today helps you to become a better version of yourself. I'm your host, Jamie Yarrow, and I hope that you have an amazing day.